श्रीमान् वेङ्कटनाथार्यः कवितार्किककेसरी वेदान्ताचार्यवर्यो मे सन्निधत्ताम् सदा हृदि स्वादयन्निह सर्वेषाम् त्रय्यन्तार्थम् सुदुर्ग्रहम् स्तोत्रयामास योगीन्द्रः तम् वन्दे यामुनाह्वयम् नमो नमो यामुनाय यामुनाय नमो नमः नमो नमो यामुनाय यामुनाय नमो नमः यत्पदाम्भोरुहध्यान विध्वस्ताशेषकल्मषः वस्तुतामुपयातोऽहम् यामुनेयम् नमामि तम्
श्रीमत्कृष्ण समाह्वाय नमो यामुन सूनवे यत्कटाक्ष एकलक्ष्याणाम् सुलभः श्रीधरः सदा नमः यामुन पाद अब्ज वेणुभिः पावित आत्मने विदित अखिल वेद्याय गुरवे विदित आत्मने नमः अचिन्त्य अद्भुत अक्लिष्ट ज्ञान वैराग्य राशये नाथाय मुनये अगाध भगवत भक्ति सिंधवे
अवबोधित वाणी माम्यथा मयि नित्यं भवदीयतां स्वयं कृपयैव मनन्य भोग्यतां भगवन् भक्तिमपि प्रयच्छमे।
As thou thyself hast awakened in me this consciousness of being eternally thine, so too, O Lord, grant me out of compassion that bhakti, which is of the nature of enjoying none but thee.
Our bodhita, bodhi means to say something, bodhi kirde. Is it called awakened, Swami?
Awakened, okay. Your voice is low.
Oh, it's okay. Can you hear me, Swami?
Right, avabodhita, bodhita, awakened, okay.
Awakened, avabodhita. Ma means myself.
Join the word, avabodhita vani.
Avabodhita vani, ma. Vani means in me.
Don't separate the word one from any.
Oh, I see.
Avabodhitavan is a single unit. And it means awakened. That's all.
Okay. Avabodhitavan means awakened. Ma means in me or myself, something like that. Yatha. Yatha means, is it you, Swami? I don't know.
First word in English.
Thou. As thou.
First word.
As. Oh, yatha means as.
Yatha means as.
Okay. Mayi nityam. Mayi nityam.
Mayi is what they call in me.
In me. Mayi means in me. Nityam means always. Eternally.
Nityam is eternal.
Bhavadiyatam.
No, just to choose those words which are easy for you.
Okay. Swayam.
Go in the order. Just choose the word which you know and which you can easily.
Kripayaiva, out of your mercy. Kripayaiva. Bhogyatam. Bhogyatam means
last line.
Enjoying. Bhogya means enjoying. Bhogyatam. Bhagavan Makti Papi.
Bhagavan is addressing the God.
The God, Bhagavan, Lord. Bhakti means devotion. Prayachame is you. Granted me.
May is me.
Very good, Swami.
Vina Venkatesham Nanato Nanathas Sada Venkatesham Smarami. Hare Venkatesham Prasida. Are you familiar with the Venkateshwara Suprabhatam? Seshadri Swami. We say in the second section of the Suprabhatam. That's what we have. Prayacha, give us fully complete prayacha. Bhaktim api prayachana. Devotion also, or even devotion. There's no word even, you cannot add even, but devotion also. Not only devotion, but also ananya bhogyata. Ananya bhogyatam prayachana. That's me. So I think English also should have this way. So grant me out of compassion, the devotion also. Of course, the English translation is nicely combined with the devotion. So, okay, that is also right. What English translation is good, is also right. So yatha has, so imam means this person. Who is that? Imam is this. What is this? Imam Nityam. Connect these two, three words. Imam Nityam Bhavadiyatam. That means, I am your property. I am your property. Remind me this. Remind me this. Imam this. Nityam permanently in my mind. Bhavadiyatam. That I belong to you. So English, eternally thine. That is what you call consciousness. That means understanding. That is not there in this. I mean, avabodhitaman, completely. Awakened this consciousness. You take the word avabodhitaman as awakened this consciousness. Then in me. Then only in me. Okay, English is different. So as though thyself. No, swayam, that is meaning of swayam. Thyself is dvayam. You yourself do it. I will, you, only you yourself can do it. I cannot make myself understand that I am your property. I am unable to do it. I am incapable of doing it. And therefore you do it. Please do it. So please, you already taught me, avabodhitamar, you already taught me, so as you have taught me, now grant me devotion. Not only grant me devotion, grant me the devotion to enjoy you. That is the meaning. So not only enjoy you only. Ananya means none but thee. None but, that's the meaning of none but is called ananya. Nobody else. I cannot enjoy anybody else. You have to give me the boon that I must enjoy you only, you alone. The word, Madam Madhurajan Shantavardhan read it as Kripaya Eva, but yim must be added. Kripaya Evam. That also is there. Kripaya Eva means by your grace only. You can take that way also. But here, Yamanacharya's word is evam. Evam means in this way. What is the method? You decide how to teach me. Kripaya evam ananya bhogyata. As you have made me realize that I am your property, and now please, kripaya, please, so out of compassion, you make me devoted and enjoy your figure, qualities, and all this, all connected with the Lord. Hey Bhagavan, O Lord. So meme here to me, meme last word meme means to me. We say always say, give it to me. Prayaccha me. That's what I completed the verse. Vina Venkatesham Nanatho Nanatha सदा वेंकटेशं स्मरामि स्मरामि हरे वेंकटेश प्रसीद प्रसीद प्रियं वेंकटेश प्रयच्छ प्रयच्छ ओके विल गो टू द कमेंट्री So this is like again when I said the swayam, it is like satyaka tyaga. That is you yourself doing. Swayameva karayati, swayameva karitvan. So padavare, 54. So Bhagavan, Yampirani, already we know that Parivatan Pillai has the patent usage of Yampirani, meaning that he belongs to us. Lord belongs to us and we belong to him. Yampirani, take the liberty, freedom to understand that we belong to him and he belongs to us. Tava asmi, remember Ramavatara Charmashloka words, Tava asmi. Then mayi enidathil, that is in me. Now we are selfish in praying to the Lord. So Yamunacharya is doing that. So in our case, when we say Stotra Ratnam, we also are involved. Therefore, each of us will be involved when we say the Stotra Ratnam. That's all. So Nityam, Endrum Irukkum, permanently existent. Imam Bhavadiyatam. Beautifully commented by Parivatan Pillai as, Inda Sheshatvattai. So I would also go one step further. Oh Lord, please obey me. Please accede to my request. I demand, rather I command that you must shower your grace on me. So Imam Bhavadiyatam. Inda Sheshatvattai. When I belong to you, I am your property. My individual soul is your property. Then it is under your control. Under your control, that's me. It is not a question of I am going out of control from the God. I am under the control of God. Yatha yappadi, as avabodhitavan arivittayo. So already you said yachate, Ramavatara Shloka, you said yachate, you must beg. So I beg now. That means I'm a slave. I'm a servant. So I must be an eternal servant. Nityam. So you already said it. So you said, Mamekam Saranam Braja, you said in Krishna's, Krishnavatara Charma Shloka, you said, Mamekam Saranam Braja. Go to me. Go to me. He said, come to me. In English and Sanskrit, you have to change over to translation correctly. So, Raja means go. Where to go? Where to go beyond the Lord or except God? Maam ekam saranam raja. Maam raja meaning come to me. Don't say maam raja means go to me. So, the God is nearby. He is in proximity. Swayam kripaya, kevala kripayale, this we already said, only by grace, only by compassion. The word only is missing in the English translation. Only by swayam kripaya. It is natural that you are always compassionate. Swayam kripaya, you do it yourself. Etad ananya bhogyatam. The word etat is not available in the verse. How does the commentary include this etat? I don't know. It should be evam. The spelling mistake in the print is etat. It is not etat, it is evam. Ananya Bhagina, the first time I think we are facing a mistake. Already one letter, I think we found fault with one letter. And here it is full word. Etat is not there. Evam is there. Evam ananya bhogyatam. Maybe you have to change the text. Say kripayaitat. Kripayaivam. It is there. Kripayaivam ananya bhogyatam. Kripayaitat ananya bhogyatam. maybe there's a different reading. So இதை தவிர வேற ஒன்றில் இனிமை உடையது அல்லாத. I don't feel anything sweeter than you. I don't feel anything better than you in quality. That is the meaning of commentator. Namely, இனிமையை உடையது அல்லாத. Lord is so sweet. பக்திமபி பக்தியையும் even the devotion, also the devotion, may prayacha adiyanukku kodukkaruvaar. When we said the word prayacha, I told you six meanings in what I call imperative mood. So you are now requesting. So please bless me. Please bless me, devotion. Ava avatarika. Ava bodhita. Atma apahara pariyayamana atma sarmapranathil aravale. Again, one letter in Tamil is missing. Atma samarpanatalavi. Ma is missing between Atma and samarpana. One ma extra. Atma is there, there is ma. And the samarpana, ma is missing. Atmapahara pariyayamana, pariyayamana, Atma samarpanatalavi. Naan nillamayale, nirhetukakrupayale, inda sheshatte unartyana pole, inda jnanam, purushartha, உபயோகியாம்படி இந்த கிருப்பையாலே தான திரைய உதித்த பரபக்தியை தந்தருள வேண்டும் என்றார். So you have a word, terse word to understand by letter, by asterisk. We will see that now before, I mean after reading the full paragraph Avatarika. After reading the full paragraph of Avatarika, we will go to. How am I? What is my position? What is my state of mind? So we say, he says, according to commentator, we say, we are doing something which is wrong. What? So we have stolen the individual soul, my individual soul from rather his individual soul from him and say, I call it mind now. Atma abhara pariyayam. Pariyayam meaning, it doesn't mean synonym. It means synonymous with the thought that I stole the soul. I made a theft. So atma abhara pariyayam. Now I am now submitting my soul because I understand that it is my soul. I wrongly understand that it is my soul. I have a wrong concept in my mind that it is my soul and therefore I am submitting it. Now I have changed my mind. So you have taught me, you have made me realize that it is not my soul. That means I have already stolen the soul from you. Therefore, I am resubmitting. Again, resubmission is also wrong. Therefore, I understand fully what is the real state. Namely, it is your soul. Naan nillamayale. No, I have become a good person. Naan nillamayale here. I am not standing steadfast on the wrong concept now. I have right understanding. That's the meaning of non nillamayal. Then what you must do, nirhetuka kripai. So you must have grace without any reason, without any basis. You should not search for some quality in me and find out whether I am fit for grace. No, you are not to do anything. No probing. No probing, yes. Causeless. Right? Don't probe into me that whether I have qualification like karma yoga, jnana yoga, bhakti yoga, prapatti yoga and so on. No condition should be imposed on me. So nirhetuka kripayale. Inda sheshatte unarthinapo. Now you have made me realize that I am your slave. So this wisdom, இந்த ஞானம். So what is the purpose of our human life? dharma, artha, kama, moksha. Dharma, performance of duty. Dharma, kama, desire. Fulfilling of the worldly desire initially. And then artha, earning money. They are linked with each other, rather complementary to each other. When I earn money, I want to fulfill our desire. And because I have desire to be fulfilled, I earn money. Then after earning money, you do your duty. Or do your duty and earn money. And because I have desire to do my duty, I earn money. So they are interlinked with each other. Then finally we aspire for moksha. And what is this moksha? Is the last purushartha, last human goal. Namely, purushartha, that's what purushartha, human goal. Upayogiyam badi. Already we saw jnanan moksha. From the wisdom we get the freedom. So what is that freedom? Freedom from birth and death. So this wisdom that I am your slave should help me to get the emancipation. Inda kripayale. So by this grace. So you have to give me a particular grace by which the knowledge that you imparted to me should be useful for achieving the beatitude. Now look at the word. Now look at, go to the fourth verse. Again, you have to take the quotation from Bhagavad Gita. 8th chapter, Ashtamadhyaya, 22nd verse, Dvavinshati Sloka. So, purushasya parapartha bhaktya labhyastva ananyaya. So, sthanatraya udita parabhakti. Parabhakti is extreme devotion. Paramabhakti is all the another stage is there. Paramabhakti is there. That is ananya bhakti. Parabhakti is devotion to the Almighty, the highest God. Paramabhakti is there is no other devotion towards any other God. That is Paramabhakti. So we are talking about Parabhakti now. Again, Parabhakti is coming out of Karma Yoga and Jnana Yoga and Bhakti Yoga. Initially, we have a smaller amount of devotion. That is Bhakti Yoga. And that Bhakti Yoga is a resultant of Karma Yoga and Jnana Yoga. So all these disciplines are practiced. Yes. Purusha paraha. So purushaha saha paraha. Lord Krishna is talking about himself. And he is there called Parama Purusha. Otherwise called Purushaha Saha Paraha. The highest primordial being. He is the man. Purushaha, paraha is the highest man. O Partha, O Arjuna, Bhaktya Labhyaha, you have to reach him by devotion to Ananyaya, not by any other means. So Bhakti Yoga is stressed as important and Parabhakti is important. Parabhakti. Then again, 1154, you have Bhaktya to Ananya Shakya, Ananyaya Shakya. It is given in the negative word, negative statement, that's all. The first one, 822 is positive, 1154 is negative. You cannot reach him without bhakti. Why should they say, it's said again. So in order to stress that Arjuna and we people who are like Arjuna, restlessness in the whole of this world, so should be practicing devotion. So, bhaktya to ananyaya shakya. There is no other means except the bhakti. It is not possible. Shakya, it is possible. Bhaktya to ananyaya shakya. What do you call exclusive devotion will make it possible for you to reach the final goal. मत भक्तिम लभते पराम अगेन ऑफ कोर्स सारी बोथ ऑल द थ्री कोटेशन फ्रॉम भगवद गीता आर ऑलवेज पॉजिटिव आई एम सॉरी आई टोल्ड यू नेगेटिव आई थॉट देयर इज वन ना लेटर देयर भक्त्या तो अनन्यया शक्य वी कैन रीच हिम ओनली बाय भक्ति ओनली बाय डिवोशन देन मत भक्तिम लभते पराम 1854 மூன்று ஸ்தானங்களில் இன் த்ரீ பிளேசஸ் இன் தி பகவத்கீதா யூ கெட் தி வேர்ட் பகத் பக்தி ஸோ பராம் பக்திம் லபதே பரா லபதே ஹையஸ்ட் டிவோஷன் இஸ் காட் இஸ் அப்டைன்ட் அண்ட் டுவர்ட் மீ மத் பக்தி மத் பக்திம் லபதே பரா ஸோ யூ வில் பி அச்சீவிங் த கிரேட்டஸ்ட் டிவோஷன் ஆன் மீ ஓவர் மீ That is called the parabhakti. So you remember these points because, of course, Sri Vaishnavites are concentrating upon prapatti. So no question of because it's very difficult. Bhakti is very difficult. So, but we must have highest devotion. We must have no other means to attain. We have to follow all the rules of bhakti and so on. It's called upasanam. In other words, upasanam, meditation. And you have 32 vidyas regarding the upasanam. And therefore, it's very difficult to follow. Now, so all the three, 822, 1154, 1854, tell us that there are three types of, three places where parabhakti has been mentioned. The word, look at the word param in 1854, paraha in 822. So there is no word paraha, maybe in the other half, the other words of the same sloka, you will find bhaktyat ananyaya shakya. Yashodas Swami will show the 1154 if possible in Sanskrit or at least in English.
So I posted it in the chat, all three in the chat.
Right. So, you, okay. That you did it for 1854, you have done it. And also for, okay. Okay. Bhaktyato ananyayal sakyaha aham evam vidho arjuna. Aham evam vidho arjuna. ज्ञातुं द्रष्टुं च तत्वेन प्रवेष्टुं च परन्तम् ओके सो दिस इज भक्ति नेमली आई कैन बी रीचेबल आई एम रीचेबल आई कैन बी रीच्ड बाय डिवोशन बट एक्सक्लूड डिवोशन एट द सेम टाइम व्हाट शुड यू डू ऑन भक्ति You have to try to understand me, jnātum, to know me, drashtum, to see me, and tattvena, by the principle, by the understanding of the highest principle, then praveshtum cha, you can enter into me. You can enter into me. That is, your so-called individual soul can enter into the Paramatma. Already Paramatma has entered into your soul, and therefore you have to enter into the Lord. So this is what we say. We, when we go to say Vaikuntham, we always say we enter into the soul, the Supreme Soul. Here it is, my dear Arjuna, Yashoda Swami can read the English translation of the 1154.
Yeah, my dear Arjuna, only by undivided devotional service can I be understood as I am, standing before you, and can thus be seen directly. Only in this way can you enter into the mysteries of my understanding.
So next one, please, 1854 also, please read.
Well, that was 1854. Yeah. You want all three?
No,
I'm sorry. That was That was not 1854. Okay, 1854 is one who is thus transcendentally situated at once realizes the supreme Brahman and becomes fully joyful. He never laments or desires to have anything. He is equally disposed toward every living entity. In that state, he attains pure devotional service unto me.
Right. So this is what I read in Sanskrit. Brahma Bhutaha Prasantatma or Prasannatma. Both are same, but Prasannatma. Na sochati na kankshati. Samaha sarveshu bhuteshu. Mad bhaktim labhate param. So here, Brahma Bhutaha, this is what we say, entering into the Supreme Soul. So I have become the Supreme Soul myself. Prasannatma, I am happy. That's what it says, becomes fully joyful. And then na sochati, never worries, never is sad. Na kankshati, no expectations. He doesn't have any desire further. Samaha sarveshu bhuteshu. This is what it has been explained in Bhagavad Gita again. Whether it is elephant or cow or cannibal or you cannot treat it differently. So samaha sarveshu bhuteshu. Equanimity in treatment to all living beings, can say. Then mad bhaktim labhate. When you treat even insentient objects as God, then no problem with identification, and therefore God will give us the grace of complete devotion. Well, 822, have you given the full time of birth? Yes. Purushasya parapartha bhaktya labhyat ananyaya. Yasyantaha antasthani bhutani yena sarvam idam tapa. Can you read the English, please?
The Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is greater than all, is attainable by unalloyed devotion. Although he is present in his abode, he is all-pervading and everything is situated within him.
This is what we say, yena sarvam idam tatam means, he is all-pervading. All creations have got the Lord there, inside. Then yasyantasthani bhutani, all the living beings are in him. They have entered into him. That is the primordial highest being. And he can be achieved only by you. Thank you for the chat with the Sanskrit verses and English meaning. So you have number Vyakhyanam in this page. Explanation. So, mai nityam bhavadiyatam avabodhitavan. Yan pakkalile niyatayana. Niyatayana meaning surely. It is definite. It has no change. No policy change. Tad vishaye sheshatayai. That is, in your case, I am a slave. So, it's a repetition. Bhavadiyatay engayale. Anya sheshatva vyavritti. This is what I have been saying it also. Namely, we are not slaves to any other being, even when it is God. So, anya sheshatva vyavritti. It cannot include any other God and slavery to any other person. Then, mai nityam endradhu. Therefore, it is permanent in you, in me. Rather, the wisdom is in me and the slavery is in you, with regard to you. Then 298, Swatvam Atmani Sanjatam Swamitvam Brahmani. Now, again I repeat. So initially I thought the individual soul is my property. And later I realized by your teaching that my soul rests, mind, my is there. So my individual soul rests, R-E-S-T-S, rests on the Paramatma, the Supreme Soul. So Sattvam, what do you call the property ownership? So Sattvam is property ownership. Is Atmani Sanjatam. Now it has come, now with my thought is transferred. Now I have changed my thought. But previously I thought the individual soul is mine. Now it is Paramatmani Sanjatam. So it has now come to the responsibility of the Supreme Soul. Then Swamitvam Brahmanishtitam. But in spite of my entering, seeing, understanding the Supreme Soul, the mastership remains with only the Lord, not me, because you say that the Supreme Soul and the individual soul have become one and one. We are not different from each other. Then you will ask, why can't I get powers of creation? Why can't I be present everywhere? So these two things are not there. Again, only on the Lord, the onerous responsibility of masterhood is it. So, Swamitvam Brahmanishtitam. So, Imam, what is that Imam? Imam and Sheshatvatil Inimiyale Kondadukara. Imam, the word meaning Imam means only this generally. Now, that means whenever we point out our own self, namely when you point out or rather introspective about the individual soul, then only when you are happy you say the word Imam. Otherwise you say that man, because this is not my individual soul. You said that it is your individual soul. The individual soul is yours, therefore I don't have any stake. I am not a stakeholder of my individual soul. Then why should I worry about? Again, I am not very happy in that same. And I don't mention the word Imam. I am not happy. Now I tell you this soul. And I say this soul. And I say this meaning. I am not referring to any other individual soul. That means I am proud that I belong to the God. In fact, I will say this way. So I am happy that I belong to God. Then I am happy that I am slave of Sriman Narayan. That is the meaning. Yatha avabodhitava yadarupadi arivikkappatte. So you have taught me right and I have understood it right. And swayam kripaya, that happened because of your grace. Your own grace. Yesterday, one of the members of WhatsApp page, WhatsApp group, sent me a joke in the group at the time 11:20 night, 11:20 p.m. And I requested him, sir, because you don't get sleep, don't disturb others' sleep by sending a joke at 11:20. And he said, I understand your feelings and so on. And he wrote back that it can happen sometimes. It can happen sometimes. Okay, very little to complete the verse. Okay. So just a deviation for understanding. So he said it can happen sometimes.
Not apologetic.
I retorted, it cannot happen. We have to stop sending messages after 10 hours. Somebody said, you have no freedom to dictate to others why to send messages or not to send some meaning. A particular message and so on. Good morning. Then they send good morning message. They only forward message. They are not writing the word mom. They are so lethargic. They are so idle. Rather idle in the sense lazy. Lazy to write in English or something. They are writing good morning in India. I said, we are not in USA to write good morning. We are in India. You have to say Kale Vanakkam. Then again, you forward something. Some forwards a lot of advice. I said, nobody likes advice. And I said it cannot happen. We have to put a full stop to sending messages after 10 o'clock. So what they will say is, you leave the group. You exit the group. Let me think. Yeah, Kale Vanakkam. And another deviation. One of my friends, a very great scholar in Sanskrit in Chennai, and he said, do you know the importance of good morning, good evening, good night messages? I said, no, I hate them. And he said, it's very important because there are old people living alone in every house. Very old people living alone in every house. And every day, you send a good morning message to in the group or in, to him or her, who is very old. He will give back, he will reply the message and say, good morning to you also. Then if he doesn't send the good morning message back, he doesn't reply, then you have to suspect that he is ill, he is sick, and he is also dead. So visit his house, go to his house, if he is nearby, and find out whether he is alive. It's very important, this, the Sanskrit scholar said. Good morning message is very important, because if they don't reply. Today, said in the class, don't send emojis. A gentleman in the class gave the salutation emoji. And then he asked me a question, a doubt in the stotra. I said, did you read the message already sent to you as an introduction to the stotra? He said, no. Then why do you send emoji? Why do you send this salutation? That means you don't want us to see send the message. உங்க தமிழ்ல சொன்னாதான் புரியாது. உங்களுக்கு கும்பிடு ஒரு கும்பிடு, நீங்க வந்து பேசவே வேண்டாம். டோன்ட் டாக் வித் மீ. உங்களுக்கு ஒரு கும்பிடு போட்டு I just told them rather harshly, don't send the emojis. Everybody sends the emojis. And they are putting this salutation. 1, 2, I said, by that I can understand whether Yashodhas Swami belongs to Tengale Sampradaya or Vadagale Sampradaya. One means Tengale or a Smartha. Two means Vadagale. Two even. Four means Vadagale, definitely Vadagale. And Ahobalamattam, something like that. So, that's some deviation. Okay, let us finish as the words finish. And in the last paragraph on 54, page. Kevalam Kripayale, Swayam Kevalam. In Tamil, Kevalam is Kevalam. Kevalam is mean, M-E-A-N in Tamil. So Kevalam is only in Sanskrit. Yetad Ananya Bhogyatam, Idoriya Venandrum Nenjik Vishaya Mahadabadi Irukkum Bhogyateya Udaitana Bhakti. How do we enjoy the Lord? Not by physical parts, but by mind, but by heart. The 11th sense organ is used to enjoy. Our thoughts enjoy. So that is the one. So Bhagavan, look at the beautiful explanation. Onrai oruthanukku kudupom endral, oru thadaiyillada jnana sakthi adigalal poornan. Keshavdas Swami request the Lord. I as Trinarayanan request the Lord. Madam request the Lord. Keshavdas Swami Seshadri Swami requests a lot. So all of us request the same, with the same goal. And Bhagavan is the word which means Onrai Oruthanakku Kodupom Endral. All right, he grants only Ganeshwadar. Or he grants individually, me and the other two people also, Madam and Seshadri Swami. And what is the condition of the Lord? Each one is given, granted, whatever we wanted. But there is no obstacle to jnana and shakti. We are given the power of thought. We are given the wisdom. So there is no quality difference between the requests, individuals. Jnana shakti adigalil purnam. In spite of the grant of grace on the individual souls, his knowledge is always complete. Please remember. We also get equally the wisdom in completion. In spite of it, his is rather little. Quality is more, quantity is more. Quantity of knowledge, quantum of knowledge and quality of knowledge is more with him, because only one aspect, remember one aspect, namely, we cannot understand past, present and future while initially, and we will not be able to remember the past and past, present and future completely, whereas he will remember. That's what he says to Arjuna in Bhagavad Gita. I have been born many times. You have been born many times. Oh Arjuna, you are born many times. But you don't know about your previous birth, but I know about your previous birth. So this is where we differ. Even in jnanam, there is a gradation. There is a hierarchy. So bhakti mapi prayacha. Yadurupadi jnanate tandai. Apadiye bhakti im tandurulam. Because the yoga, bhakti yoga is very difficult for me. So please, along with jnanam, along with wisdom, please also give the benefit of the devotion, your discipline, so that I will go through the devotion discipline. But what is me? What is me? What is me is, I am opposite of whatever you think about me. Oh Lord, whatever you think about me, I am opposite of what you think. What is that? Ajnanai. I am ignorant. In spite of your teaching, I am ignorant. Ashaktanai. I have no power. There is always a power cut in me. No electricity in the sense, no power in me. Ruchi matram yaayirukkire. Ruchi matrame yaayirukkire enakku. I have only desire. Tamil proverb sonnadhan puriyum. Keshavdas Swami will be given the meaning. Aasha irukku taashil panna. Adushtam irukku kazhudai meikka. Avadi Tamil la oru pozhamozhi. So yeah, I have a desire to occupy a high post. Aasha irukku, I have a desire. Tashil panna. Tashildar is the local dada, the village officer. It's called now VAO. Today it's called VAO, Village Administrative Officer. So I have a desire to occupy that post. But I have only the job available to me is to take care of the donkeys. Adrishtam irukku. So this is what. So I won't take efforts to do anything. I have a desire, but I am unwise. I am powerless, but I have right desire. I have got right desire.
What do you think about Nirhetaka Kripa? I thought that Deshika Sampradaya does not accept Nirhetaka Kripa.
Please repeat the question. Sorry.
Yeah, my first question is that it was mentioned Nirhetaka Kripa. Nir Hetuka Kripa.
Can you send it in chat?
Sure. Nir Hetuka Kripa was mentioned.
Nir Hetuka Kripa, okay.
Right, causeless grace. So my understanding was this is a more of a Tenacharya Sampradaya doctrine. And not so, is it accepted by both by Yeshika Sampradaya also, Nir Hetuka Kripa? It is. Okay, yes. Excellent. Okay, great. Okay. That my second question is, he's talking about bhakti. Please grant me bhakti. So I have a friend who is in Gaudiya Sampradaya, and he's asking this question: is bhakti inherent in the jivatman, or does it have to be granted from outside? Does it have to come from outside, from the acharya or from God? Does bhakti come from some other outside place, or is it inherent? We can do bhakti, we can do devotional acts, but can we only do devotional acts if that bhakti is infused in us?
Is very certain that you know Sankhya Tyaga is the answer for. Lord gives you an acharya, yeah, and you learn bhakti from the acharya.
Right, but is the aspect of bhakti, Is it natural for the Atman, for the Jivatman to? I mean, the Jivatman is naturally a servant of God. No, it's a slave of God. It's a property of God. So, is the quality of bhakti inherent in the Jivatman or not?
No, it is there.
It's inherent.
See, that's why it is said already. Though the word letter is meant by him as Ajnaha, then Ashaktaha, and only with the desire. I have no wisdom. I am not powerful, but I have a desire. In the same way, as you said, I have bhakti, there is no doubt. But bhakti is not in the right proportion. Bhakti is not in the right way. Rather perfect way. I won't say right. I'm not bhakti in the wrong way. But I'm not bhakti in the perfect way. And therefore, the amount, rather the quality of my devotion should be improved by an acharya, by the grace of the Lord.
So the individual, the jivatman, that has got some form of bhakti, has some desire to worship the God, to serve God, but that is not a perfect desire. That has to be cultivated by the acharya, the instructions of the acharya, and by the grace of God. That becomes that there are different stages, and as you said, there is the stages of Paragyana and Parama Bhakti. So the initial stage is what? What is the initial stage, the first stage?
We also say when we go to an acharya, Lord induces us to go to an acharya. No? Even the beginning stage, he is responsible to make us go to an acharya. And right. He directs the acharya to advise you.
Right, in Sri Vachana Bhushanam, Hila Lokacharya, he says that somehow or other, everything, the Lord is making us do everything. He's doing everything through us. He's actually doing everything. So he makes us to control the mind, and the mind controls the senses. And after the mind and senses and the body are controlled, then he sends Acharya. Then we surrender to the Acharya. And then the Acharya gives us Dakshina Mantra to us and Dvaya Mantra, and he helps us to cultivate, helps us to do property, but also to cultivate devotional activities also. So the bhakti changes and goes up in level through the agency of the Acharya and through practice, through sadhana, the bhakti goes up. But still, we are not doing bhakti yoga. We're not doing it for moksha, but we are doing it for the pleasure of God, for Bhagavad Pratityatam. And the ten acharyas say we are doing it for Bhagavad Agyaya, Bhagavad Kainkarya Rupam. So same thing, really. We want to please God. All of us want to please God. And so we do devotional acts to please God. As we do more and more of them, our bhakti becomes Paragyana and Parama Bhakti. Even in this lifetime, it becomes Parama Bhakti or not? It can. Yeah. Right. So also we were reading today in Mumukshapati that there are two ways that the individuals like Draupadi and Vibhishana and Gajendra, they all made an effort to perform property, to do property. They all did property. But he was saying that Namalwar didn't do anything. He was granted moksha by the Lord without doing anything. And so can we understand that the example of Namalwar is like a Jivan Mukta? So because we don't accept Jivan Mukta usually, but Namalwar seems to be like a Jivan Mukta. He doesn't eat, he doesn't sleep. He doesn't drink water. His whole life he doesn't do these things. He is like a Jivan Mukta. What is the difference between what Namalwar's life and Jivan Mukti?
There are so many points in your discussion. Number one, initially, suppose we plunge into bhakti, knowing that is the right path, and that is because of the limited freedom that we have been given. That was also an initiation, as I said, by the Lord. Our good thought of practicing bhakti with our limited freedom before we realize that the grace has come in large measure. So we think that we have made a first step towards approaching an acharya for devotion. That is one thing. That is the first point. Later on, that we must realize that everything is the Lord, God's act, and we will understand His full grace also. That is later. The other point I wanted to say, I think because you continued on Namalwar, and about Namalwar, as you said, he is like a Jivan Mukta, but he is not Jivan Mukta. Because we understand that Namalwar doesn't do all normal activities of a human being. And again, as you said, God has chosen him to grant him the prapatti, the bhakti yoga or even the moksha. Whereas others are not chosen so quickly. For example, Rama chose Dasaratha as his father. He is given there. He chose Dasaratha as his father. That means, of course, you find in Ramayana, Dasaratha is in heaven, not in Vaikuntha. And he comes back. And comes back and instructs Rama. And Kaikeyi also is instructed by Dasaratha. And so on. So, but Dasaratha's final destination is moksha. There is no doubt about it. Only an intermediary place of life is heaven. Heaven. That is it. So in the same way, there are some people who have been chosen by God to grant bhakti as well as moksha. Moksha is assured to Namalwar. Moksha is assured to Namalwar, but he did not. But he sang the songs by the very activity that he sang the songs, 1000 Thiruvaimudi. You can understand he is not a new. He is the only extraordinary personality who has been blessed specially by him. That's all. But I wanted to add some point, which if you can repeat what you said.
Yeah, in the middle, I was in the beginning. I was talking about the stages of bhakti. So I was saying after one approaches an acharya, then the acharya teaches him bhakti, and he goes from stage to stage. So one is advancing throughout his life from bhakti to padagyana, parama bhakti, like this, even in this lifetime.
Afterward, you said something more.
So I started off, okay.
One thing I can do, we can listen to the recording of your.
Yeah, that's okay. Meeting. We'll talk about it later. See, this morning we're also discussing about Pilalokacharya. He mentions these two different ways of property, Paragata Svikara and Swagata Svikara. So he says that when Rama accepted Hanuman and Guha, that was Paragata Svikara. The Lord himself chose them like he chose Namalwa. He chose to give them shelter, to give them moksha.
You mean Sugriva and Guha?
Guha and Hanuman. Yeah. The examples are Guha and Hanuman. Oh. And they say that this is a better way than Swagata Svikara. Swagata Svikara means that the living being makes a request for property. Vedanta Deshika in Rahasya Trayasara chapter 23 and 24, he says, you must make a request to be saved. If you don't make a request, the God will not save you. Because otherwise God will save everybody. So he says this is Swagata Svikara, but he says sometimes this doesn't work, and he gives the example of Bharata. Bharata made the request of Rama to stay in Ayodhya, but Rama would not stay. So Bharata's Sharanagati to Rama to stay in Ayodhya was unsuccessful. There is successful property or Sharanagati and unsuccessful. This was unsuccessful. So because it was initiated, self-initiated property by Bharata. So anyway, we were discussing this, that there is some little bit of difference of opinion and outlook between these two types of Sharanagati. One is self-initiated, and one is initiated by the Lord. So it's called Paragata Svikara and Swagata Svikara. Have you heard of this?
Who gave the concept of these two, Paragata Svagata Svikara?
Yeah, Pilalokacharya and Manavala Mahamuni. So it may be only a Tengalai concept.
Concept, yeah.
Yeah. Concept. So that's why I asked you about Nirhetika Kripa, because Nirhetika Kripa means the God gives you a kripa, God gives you grace, but there's no cause for it. So Vedanta Deshika says there should be a request. There should be a request to be saved. So if we say there's a request to be saved, it means there's always a cause for moksha. The cause is the request. It's a small cause, but it's a cause. It's an excuse. God takes an excuse to save us because we make an appeal to him. Save us.
This we have discussed many times, because it is the word of Sriman Narayana in Pancharatra, like Lakshmi Tantra and so on. Raksha peksham apekshate. We have been discussing on this. And we said also aprachitaha na gopaye. These two sentences we have been repeating many times. Number one.
This is from Pancharatra? Pancharatra.
Yeah, Pancharatra.
Lakshmi Tantra or some other place?
Lakshmi Tantra. Pancharatra itself is the word of God. Straight. And so Lakshmi Tantra is only one of the branches of Pancharatra.
But in Lakshmi Tantra, we get the Anukulya Sisankalpa mantra.
And again. Okay. Okay. Thank you.
It's getting late for Mrs. Varadarajan, so she's leaving. Right. So what I'm saying is, in the 17th chapter of Lakshmi Tantra comes this Anukulya Sisankalpa Pratikulya Sivarjana Saranga Sharanagatihi.
Very rare is the choice just made by Lord to grant moksha, and therefore they are so very fortunate to get it from the Lord, like Namarva. And so, when you say Guha and Hanuman as example, I won't say Hanuman as an example, but Guha, he went to the forest and gave him benefit of universal brotherhood. And also, of course, Sugriva. Vibhishana, of course, came to surrender. Therefore, it's only Swagata Svikara.
Can we give an example? Can we say maybe the Paragata Svikara is very, 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 very rare, and we should not count on that for our process? And it is like an honorary degree, which is given in a university to somebody who is deserving, but he hasn't actually gone through the process.
No. Paragata Svikara lies with Ravana's example also.
Oh.
He went to Sri Lanka from Ayodhya. So Ravana is Paragata Svikara. And because he was the security staff in Vaikuntha, They were cursed to be born in this earth for three
births. Right, Jaya Vijaya. Yeah, right. And that is, right, very good point.
So it is Paragata Svikara. And again, your contention, rather, if you say through some other Acharya, Manavala, Bharata Sharanagati was unsuccessful, that is also bad. That is also not right. Why? Because Bharata Sharanagati is superseded by the boon given to Kaikeyi. Though Kaikeyi and Bharata are mother and son in relation, so you don't call, never call that Bharata Sharanagati is unsuccessful. It's a very different term. Instead of that, what is that in Shastra is, which dharma is superior to which dharma? So there is a difference between two dharmas. So what to follow and what not to follow. So Dasaratha is to be made a true, truth-speaking man. And he is not to be made a liar. That is the purpose of going to the forest. And mother's boon should not be broken by the son. See, mother's word is final. Matra Devo Bhava, he was not Matra Devo Bhava. Therefore, he can be rejected outright. So don't call any time Bharata Saranagati unsuccessful. And what you call Samanya Dharma and Vishesha Dharma, Vishesha Dharma becomes supreme in Samanya Dharma. That is why we say in ordinary, simple situation, You can tell a lie, in particular instances, in marriage, in death, in emergency. Get it from Pratima Natakam of Vasa, Vivahe, Abat Kale, that way. You can tell a lie. Then it is Vishesha Dharma. That is, somebody is driving a cow to, running after a cow to kill it and take it to a butcher shop. You say that this cow has gone the other way. You tell a lie that you wanted to save the cow. So there it is not a lie. Satyam bruyat, priyam bruyat, nasatyam apriyam. Priyanchan na andritam bruyat, yesha dharma sanatana. This is the verse. So that is called Samanya Dharma and Vishesha Dharma. Vishesha Dharma overtakes the Samanya Dharma, and therefore don't call it as Bharata's Sharanagiti is unsuccessful.
Right. Very good point.
Instead, Bharata Sharanagiti is more successful because he took the Paduka. Paduka Rajyam was better than Rama's kingdom. Whereas in Rama's kingdom, a child died and a caste man, or a low caste man who is not eligible to do tapas, he did tapas. And therefore, these two incidents did not happen in Paduka Rajyam. As well as the Paduka Rajyam had the tenfold income to the government. And Bharata resubmitted the kingdom to him. And
Very good.
He will say, Dasharatha was made a liar because when she wanted Bharata to become a king, that did not happen. So do you say that one boon is successful and the other boon is unsuccessful? That means Dasharatha is a liar. No, Dasharatha is not a liar. Dasharatha was a true person, therefore he was chosen as a father. And asking Rama to go to the father for 14 years, that happened. That boon was fulfilled. The other boon was not fulfilled. And Bharata did not become the king. But instead, he performed the king's duties as a servant to Paduka.
So, is it common to talk about Paduka Rajyam is greater than Rama Rajyam? Paduka Rajyam is known amongst Sri Vaishnavas as better than Rama Rajyam.
What is that Paduka Rajyam? I mean.
Yeah, Paduka Rajyam is better than Rama Rajyam.
Right.
Wow. So
That is again because Lord gives more freedom to the devotees. Paduka is a devotee of Lord, and he is ready to get insulted when the devotee gets an upper hand. He belittles himself. God lowers down himself, and then in order to highlight the supremacy of the devotee. My question is whether Mumukshu Padi gives such an idea that Bharata's Saranagati is unsuccessful.
According to my edition, yeah. I mean, we don't say, of course, ultimately Bharata's Sharanagati was successful because ultimately, like you said, the Padukas were there, but also eventually Rama came back, but it took some time. If we want both of the things to come true, if we want Dasaras, idea to come true, and also Bharata's idea to come true, but Bharata's took some time for Rama to come back. But I don't know exactly how I haven't seen the Manipravala of Manavala Bhamuni's commentary, but this is what is in my translation. It's a footnote. So
again, I tell you now. Categorically, we read the Stotaratna, okay, the original text from Yamanatha. We read the commentary of Periyavachantula. What is to be believed more? The original text of Yamanacharya, as understood rightly by Periyavachantula. Suppose Periyavachantula makes a mistake, then you cannot depend on Periyavachantula. Commentator is not the proof of authority. Commentator helps us to understand more. And if there is a fallacy, if there is a wrong idea, then we cannot take it up.
And yeah, I agree with you.
the same way, footnote cannot be dependable.
Right. And so now we have to also look at the, we also have to look at, it will be nice to also see the commentary on Stotra Ratna by Vedanta Deshika as well.
Right.
To compare.
And again, of course, opinions differ and our views also differ. And in the case of what you call Hanuman, I think I cannot accept that word Paragata Svikara for Hanuman. Hanuman did not do any Sharanagati. Hanuman was not granted anything. Except, of course, Hanuman did not want to come to Vaikuntha, and therefore he remains here even now. Even now he remains here. That's what he said, I don't want to be there. I want to hear your name every time. Yatra yatra Raghunatha Kirtanam, tatra tatra. Therefore, I don't want to leave this pleasure. If you say Guha, Sugriva, and even take, for example, all the sages in the forest, when did they surrender to Rama earlier in some other incarnation? No. They felt trouble. They felt very untold miseries from the hands of demons. And then he went to, that is all of Paragata Svikara, killing all the demons on the way. Viradha, Kapandha, so many. In case of Krishna also, Aghasura, Bakasura, Keshi, Kapitasura, Dhenukasura. How many demons did gopis made a surrender? No. They came, Putana came to kill only Krishna. Kamsa sent all these beautiful emissaries. And then he did not come, Krishna did not wait for Sharanagati from the gopis or the gopas. All this was done in very quick succession. At the age of 1.5. Because comes an order, 1.5 year old children, he calculated the time of birth and date of birth, and then he was a clever person, intelligent. Comes an intelligent.
Svadayanniha sarvesham trayantartham sudurgraham stotrayamasa yogindraha. तं वंदे यामुनाह्वयम् नमो नमो यामुनाय यामुनाय नमो नमः नमो नमो यामुनाय यामुनाय नमो नमः यत्पदाम्भोरुहध्यान विध्वस्ता शेषकल्मषः वस्तुतामुपयातोऽहम् यामुनेयं नमामितम्
श्रीमत्कृष्ण समात्वाय नमो यामुन सूनवे यत्कटाक्ष एकलक्ष्याणां सुलभः श्रीधरः सदा नमः यामुन पाद अब्ज वेणुभिः पावित आत्मने विदित अखिल वेद्याय गुरवे विदित आत्मने
कवितार्किक सिंहाय कल्याण गुणशालिने श्रीमते वेंकटेशाय वेदांत गुरवे नमः।